what we've seen is an incredible decrease, about a 50% decrease in the rate of death due to heart disease over the period of my career. We've never seen anything like this in any other disease at any time in history. But just in the last few years, that progress seemed to halt, and actually event rates started to rise again.
As you've been in the CV space for so long, what have you seen over the last 35 years as the evolution of CV disease, Steve?
We've made a lot of progress. You know, if I go back to when I was in my early training, if you came into the coronary care unit with a heart attack, with a myocardial infarction, all we could do is put you in a cool, dark place, give you morphine, and hope you didn't die. We had no statins, no really effective drugs to lower cholesterol. And so what we've seen is an incredible decrease, about a 50% decrease in the rate of death due to heart disease over the period of my career. We've never seen anything like this in any other disease at any time in history.
And Steve, certainly you've played a significant role in terms of decreasing that 50%. So as we think about the cardiovascular disease landscape over the last 20 years, as you noted, there's been a significant decrease, and there's no other disease similar to this in terms of the decrease in terms of morbidity and mortality. However, over the last 2.5 years, we've seen that reversal in terms of the trend in terms of cardiovascular disease, Steve.
We've seen this incredible decrease in cardiovascular event rates. But just in the last few years, even pre-COVID, that progress seemed to halt, and actually event rates started to rise again. The obesity epidemic now in developed countries is beginning to reverse the gains that we've made. And this is another example where we need to work with the pharmaceutical industry to develop better therapies for obesity. And I'm going to predict an explosion of new therapies as we work together with industry. And I think we're going to beat this disease, but it's going to take some innovation. And we're making some progress and we're getting there.
What do you foresee as the future? Where do you think we'll go from here?
I actually think there are opportunities. Let me see if I can kind of list some of them. Certainly cholesterol lowering. You know, we're not done yet, but we're getting pretty close to being able to treat everybody. I think we need new blood pressure drugs, and I think there are some that are being developed for what's known as resistant hypertension, high blood pressure that resists the usual agents. And there's some very good innovations being done there. And the innovation in diabetes treatment, which is, of course, a huge epidemic, the progress we've made in diabetes treatment is just remarkable. And we now have many new drugs that are very effective. However, prevention is always better than treatment. And my view of this is that until we can get cardiovascular disease to not be the number one killer, we got more work to do. And that's something, of course, that keeps me going. I'm 73 years old. I'm not going to quit until we get there. And I want to see in my lifetime, I want to see cardiovascular disease no longer be the number one killer.